Hi students, today I want to explain about chemical bonding chapter. Chemical bonding. Here, what is a chemical bond? How we can define a chemical bond? Means chemical bond, how we can define means chemical bond is considered as the attractive forces between two oppositely charged, suppose A and B is taken, the attractive forces between two oppositely charged ions, or the attractive forces between two atoms, or the attractive forces between two species, suppose here because of the attractive forces they are forming AB molecule. So the attractive forces between two oppositely charged atoms or ions or species is called as simply chemical bond. It may contain opposite charges also. In this molecule, between the oppositely charged ions, there is electrostatic attractive forces. Okay, and this is called chemical bonding. What is the reason why the chemical bond formation occurs? Why the atoms combine, or why the atoms are participating in the chemical bond formation? Here the main and two important reasons we have. One is to minimize energy, or to reduce their energy. By reducing their energy, what happens? They become more stable. And second one is to get stable configuration, inert gas configuration. To get stable inert gas configuration. Okay, the main reasons they observed, scientists observed, is these two. One is to minimize their energy. Suppose if you are taking a graphical representation like this, here we are taking A and B, two atoms, like this they are present, and here the equilibrium distance between them, and whenever they are meeting, the energy decreases and slowly increases like this. Here it is energy curve and it is the interatomic distance we are taking. It is called as interatomic distance. Whenever they are combining, here if it has taken, this is having the minimum energy, and at this minimum energy, the A and B combine and forms a molecule. And when they are coming very close, then what happens? Again, the repulsion between them increases, and so they are becoming far apart from each other. Okay, a chemical bond is formed to minimize the energy, and second, to get stable inert gas configuration. As we studied, in the entire periodic table there is only one molecule, sorry, only one group which is having a completely filled configuration, and those elements will not participate in any chemical reaction, and they are called as the inert gases. And basing on this, Causal and Lewis proposed a theory. Here, Causal and Lewis proposed a theory. According to this theory, every atom, or in the periodic table, the elements which are present will always try to participate in chemical reaction to get the octet configuration. Here it is octet configuration. Octet configuration means NH2NP6 configuration, or it is also called as 8 electron configuration, or to get the duplet configuration. Here duplet configuration means NH2 or helium configuration. So either octet configuration or for duplet configuration they are trying to get. Means suppose hydrogen is taken, it gets nearest to helium configuration to become more stable. Or if lithium is taken, it gets the nearest helium configuration to become more stable. So any element will try to get the octet configuration by losing or gaining or by sharing of electrons. And in this they also proposed octet theory or octet role. So what is octet role means? Every atom will try, or an atom of an element will always try to possess 8 electron configuration. 8 electron configuration in its valence shell, for its stability. That is called as octet rule, and there is some exceptions for the octet rule. Exceptions, or we can say them as deviation. Deviation from the octet rule. Here in the exceptions from octet rule, we can say first type is electron deficient. Electron deficient molecules. Electron deficient molecules. Here electron deficient molecules means, example we can write all third A group elements, or it is also called as 13th group elements will be considered as electron deficient molecules. And second one, electron rich. Here 13th group or 13th group elements, how means 13th group halides. If 13th group hydrides, or if 13th group halides are taken, then they act as a electron deficient. For example, BCl3 or B2H6, these can act as a electron deficient molecules. They are having less than 8 electrons in their outer shells. And second type is electron rich molecules. Here electron rich molecules means, here example for this is PCl5, SF6, IF7. So these molecules, when we are taking, these are having more than octet configuration. Here if PCl5 is taken, the central phosphor atom is a 5th group element or 15th group element. It gives 5 electrons for bonding, and chlorine is giving 5 electrons for bonding. So at phosphorus, so how many electrons present means it is 10 electrons. So in total it contains 10 electrons, and sulfur is having 12 electrons, and iodine is having 14 electrons in total. So they are more than 8 electron containing in their valency shell. So they are called as electron rich molecules or electron efficient molecules. And the third type of molecules are pseudo inert gas configuration. Pseudo inert gas configuration containing molecules. Here pseudo inert gas configuration containing molecules means, in their valency shell 18 electrons containing molecules. This is also called as nickel group configuration, or it is also called as pseudo inert gas configuration. Example for these molecules, pseudo inert gas configuration containing molecules, is Cu plus, Az plus, Au plus, and Zn plus 2, Hg plus 2. Okay, so these type of molecules, Cd plus 2 is also considered. These type of molecules are called as pseudo inert gas configuration containing molecules. And these type of compounds, along with that, the fourth type I am writing, odd electron molecules. Here odd electron molecules means NO, NO2, ClO2. These molecules are having odd number of electrons. Nitrogen, it contains 7 electrons. Oxygen contains 8 electrons. 7 plus 8, 15. So it is an odd number of electrons. Similarly, NO2, ClO2 is all having odd number of electrons. So such type of odd electron molecule formation we can't explain by using octet rule, or the electron deficient molecule which is formed even though they are not having octet configuration is not explained by this octet rule. Electron rich molecule formation, pseudo inert gas configuration containing molecules, will not be explained by the octet rule. Okay.